In the pulsing heart of the city that never sleeps, amidst the glass and steel skyscrapers of Manhattan, lived Dwayne Lancaster. He was a successful businessman, the owner of a chain of sophisticated restaurants that dotted the city's chicest neighborhoods. His name was synonymous with quality and elegance, and people gathered in his establishments to experience the exquisite cuisine he offered. Dwayne was married to Victoria, a stunningly beautiful woman who could be compared to a Greek goddess. She had eyes of such a deep and icy blue that they seemed capable of penetrating the soul of anyone who met them. Together, they formed the perfect couple, successful, attractive, and envied by all. However, behind the shiny facade of their seemingly perfect life, Dwayne harbored a silent pain that corroded his heart. He always had a subtle intuition, an uncomfortable feeling at the back of his mind, that Victoria was not being faithful to him. This insidious suspicion was devastatingly confirmed when, on a cold night, Dwayne stumbled upon a series of love messages on his phone. The sweet and intimate words were addressed to Victoria and signed by a man named Daniel Foster. Each word was like a stab in Dwayne's heart. Confronted with the betrayal, Dwayne decided to confront Victoria. He waited until nightfall, when the sounds of the city quieted down and the only light came from the soft glow of the lamps in their luxurious living room. With a trembling but firm voice, he showed Victoria the messages he had found. Victoria, with her icy blue eyes reflecting a mixture of surprise and coldness, denied everything. She insisted that Daniel was just a friend, that the messages were innocent. However, to Dwayne, each word of hers seemed like another lie, another betrayal. Dwayne's world, once full of success and happiness, crumbled around him, leaving him in a sea of despair and betrayal. Still reeling from Victoria's revelation, Dwayne was determined to find answers. Despite her denial, a silent fury ignited within him, fueling his determination to confront Daniel. Dwayne dreamed of facing him, eye to eye, and questioning the man who was destroying his marriage. However, before he had the opportunity to confront him, fate intervened in a cruel and irreversible way. Dwayne went to meet Daniel at his luxury apartment, located in one of the most impressive skyscrapers in Manhattan, but found him lifeless. The white walls of the elegant loft were stained with traces of violence, a horrific image that contrasted with the usual sophistication of the place. Due to the circumstances, Dwayne quickly became the prime suspect. The initial suspicion gave way to formal accusations as evidence began to emerge, each one seeming to consolidate Dwayne's guilt. First, there was the heated argument between Dwayne and Daniel, which was witnessed in a local bar known for its aged whiskey and live jazz. The raised voices of Dwayne and Daniel, although muffled by the sound of the trumpet, drew the attention of the bar's patrons. Dwayne's contorted face, the rage in his eyes, became a portrait engraved in the memory of all those present. Next, Dwayne's fingerprints were found at the crime scene, particularly on the entrance door and the broken lamp in Daniel's apartment. The police concluded that Dwayne had been there on the day of the murder, further solidifying suspicion against him. Finally, threatening messages to Daniel were recovered from Dwayne's phone. The angry and desperate words painted a picture of a betrayed man, eager for revenge. Dwayne was arrested and tried by a jury of his peers, men and women who looked at him with eyes full of suspicion and fear. The evidence was overwhelming, and despite his insistence of innocence, Dwayne was found guilty of Daniel's murder. The life that Dwayne had meticulously built, stone by stone, was now in ruins. The accomplishments, the success, the image he had created over the years, had all disintegrated into a fine dust. He was left to face the consequences of a crime that vehemently and desperately insisted he had not committed. As he sat alone in his cell, a sense of desolation engulfed him. Despite having achieved so much in his life, he did not have many people to turn to. The irony of the situation did not escape him. Here was Dwayne Lancaster, the man who had built a gastronomic empire, now alone and abandoned. A flashback invaded Dwayne's mind, transporting him away from the cold, gray walls of his cell, and back to the golden cornfields of Iowa. Before Victoria, before opulence, success, and tragedy, he was just Dwayne, a boy with dreamy eyes growing up in a picturesque village that seemed too small for his aspirations. He remembered that time with a mix of longing and pain. His childhood was marked by long, sunny days spent running through the cornfields under the Midwestern blue sky, and quiet nights under a starry sky that seemed vast enough to swallow all his dreams. His love for cooking began in his grandmother's humble and welcoming kitchen, where he was raised after his parents passed away. There, among cast iron pots and an old oak table, Dwayne learned the secrets of cooking with love and dedication. He remembered the smell of freshly baked apple pie, the bubbling stew on the stove, and the way his grandmother kneaded the dough with an almost tangible tenderness. These memories formed the foundation of his passion, which would guide him on his journey. Adolescence brought with it a restlessness that seemed bigger than Dwayne himself. While his friends were content with the quiet life of the countryside, Dwayne felt a pressing need for something more, something bigger. He knew he had to pursue his dream, even if it meant leaving behind everything he knew. Determined to turn his dreams into reality, Dwayne said goodbye to his childhood village and embarked on a journey to the city that never sleeps, Manhattan. It was a vibrant metropolis, a concrete and steel jungle that contrasted strongly with the open plains of Iowa. But it was also a city that breathed opportunities, a place where dreams could come true if you worked hard enough. And so began the next chapter in Dwayne's life. A boy from Iowa with dreams bigger than his small town could support. Now a man in a big city, ready to conquer the world. In Manhattan, Dwayne worked in various restaurants, starting as a kitchen assistant and slowly but steadily climbing the ladder of success. He saved every penny he earned, dreaming of the day he would open his own restaurant. It was on a cold December day, while Manhattan was engulfed in the magic of winter, that Dwayne met Victoria. The sky was sprinkled with snowflakes falling softly, covering the streets with a white and silent blanket. The air was fresh and filled with the sweet and woody smell of roasted chestnuts being sold on the corners. She appeared like an apparition, walking confidently towards him, dressed in a white fur coat that contrasted with her dark hair. Her eyes, the deepest and coldest blue, shone intensely under the soft light of the Christmas decorations that adorned the city. Victoria entered Dwayne's life like a snowstorm, quick, ruthless, and completely unexpected. She was a whirlwind of energy and passion that enveloped him, leaving him breathless and completely in love. From the first glance, from the first touch, Dwayne knew she was different from all the other women he had ever met. Their dating was turbulent and intense, like a carousel spinning at high speed. There were moments of pure joy, when it seemed they were flying together, and moments of deep uncertainty, when the reality of life made itself felt. But amidst it all, there was an undeniable connection, a magnetic attraction that bound them together. They married in an intimate ceremony, held at one of Dwayne's restaurants, a hidden gem in Manhattan with a view of the city skyline. Surrounded by family and friends, they exchanged vows of love and fidelity, promising to stay together in sickness and in health, in wealth and in poverty. At that moment, Dwayne thought he had found happiness, the missing piece in his life. He looked at Victoria, his beautiful wife, and saw a future of love and joy. But happiness, as he would later discover, was as fleeting as a leaf being carried away by the wind. And life, with its ruthless way of changing the course of things, had other plans for Dwayne Lancaster. Now, sitting alone in his cell, Dwayne wondered where it had all gone wrong. How had he fallen so low? He ran his hands through his hair, trying to push away the pain and sadness that threatened to consume him. But amidst the darkness, a flame of hope still burned. Dwayne knew he was innocent and was determined to fight to the end to prove it. Even though loneliness surrounded him, he clung to the only thing he had left, the search for the truth. While Dwayne Lancaster faced the harsh reality of his prison cell, fighting against the injustice of a crime he swore he didn't commit, his wife, Victoria, seemed to continue her life with a frightening calmness. The city of Manhattan continued to pulsate around her, indifferent to her suffering, and Victoria seemed to personify that indifference. Victoria walked the busy streets with a cold serenity, her icy blue eyes reflecting nothing but indifferent calm. Her lips occasionally curved into a smile, her behavior revealing nothing of the storm that had descended upon her life. To the outside world, it was as if nothing had happened. However, behind the scenes, a figure was working tirelessly to uncover the truth. Sam Hudson, a private detective with sharp eyes and a keen mind, had been hired by Dwayne before his arrest. Sam's task was clear: to uncover the truth behind Daniel Foster's murder. Sam was a man of few words but decisive action. He spent his days and nights scouring the lives of Dwayne, Victoria, and Daniel, searching for any clues that could shed light on the case. Among files, photographs, and testimonies, he constructed the web of relationships and events that led to that fateful night. In his dimly lit office, Sam talked to his assistant, a young aspiring detective named Jake. "Jake, there's something wrong with this story. Dwayne has motives, yes, but there's something missing," murmured Sam, his eyes fixed on the photos scattered on the table. "What do you mean, boss?" asked Jake, looking at Sam with curiosity. "I don't know yet, but we'll find out. We need to keep digging," replied Sam, determination shining in his eyes. While Dwayne waited in his cell, his only hope was the tireless work of Sam Hudson. And Sam was determined not to disappoint. He knew that every minute counted, and he wouldn't rest until the truth was uncovered. Sam Hudson, the private detective hired by Dwayne, was a war veteran with a sharp mind and a unique ability to see beyond appearances. Throughout his investigation, he discovered that Victoria Lancaster was much more than she appeared. Behind her charming smile and icy blue eyes, there was a cunning and ruthless woman. Sam discovered that over the years, Victoria had been systematically embezzling money from Dwayne's businesses, amassing an illicit fortune. Her plan was to run away with Daniel Foster, her lover, and leave her husband behind, abandoned and ruined. However, things changed when Daniel had a crisis of conscience and decided to reveal everything to Dwayne. As the rain fell heavily on the city, turning the streets of Manhattan into rivers of water and light, Sam worked diligently in his office, gathering all the evidence of Victoria and her nefarious actions. He discovered that, realizing her secret was in danger, Victoria made a shocking decision. She killed Daniel to protect her secret and ensure her plan was not discovered. Proving Victoria's guilt would be a Herculean task, given the mountain of incriminating evidence against Dwayne and Victoria's ability to manipulate the situation in her favor. Sam realized that to bring Victoria to justice, he would need to use her own manipulative nature against her. He decided to set a trap for Victoria, orchestrating a careful and cunning plan that would lead her to reveal the truth. With the help of his assistant Jake, Sam infiltrated Victoria's circle of friends and confidants, gaining her trust and watching her closely. As the days passed and Sam put his plan into action, the tension grew. He knew that one false move could ruin everything. However, Sam's determination to bring justice for Dwayne and expose Victoria was unwavering. With patience and persistence, Sam finally managed to gather the evidence he needed to expose Victoria as the true killer and free Dwayne from the clutches of injustice. The pieces of the puzzle finally fell into place, revealing the dark portrait of a woman who, with her cold heart and unchecked ambition, had destroyed the lives of those around her. Victoria Lancaster's luxurious apartment, located in the heart of Manhattan, was bathed in golden afternoon light when Sam Hudson confronted her. The walls, decorated with expensive artwork and sophisticated furniture, reflected the wealth that Victoria had accumulated at her husband's expense. Sam, dressed in his usual trench coat and fedora hat, entered the apartment, his cold and determined gaze fixed on Victoria. She was sitting on a velvet sofa, a glass of red wine in one hand, looking at Sam with a surprised and disdainful expression. "Victoria," Sam began, keeping his tone calm and controlled. "I have irrefutable evidence that Dwayne is the killer. I have everything I need to ensure that he spends the rest of his life in prison." Victoria shuddered slightly but quickly regained her composure. She looked at Sam, her icy blue eyes narrowed. "And what do you want from me, detective?" she asked, her voice cold. Sam pretended to hesitate, looking at Victoria with a calculated gaze. I know you love him, Victoria. I know you would do anything to protect him. So, I am willing to offer a deal. If you help me find evidence, I can create a new version and incriminate someone else and ensure Dwayne's freedom. But for that, I need a good sum of money, as it is very risky, but your husband will be free and by your side. For a moment, Victoria seemed to consider the proposal. Then, she gave a resigned sigh and began to give a wicked laugh. And why would I want that dead weight in my free life? She said, her voice barely above a whisper. I'll confess. I killed Daniel. I had no choice. He was going to tell everything to Dwayne and I couldn't let that happen. I still needed his inheritance badly. But now that he's behind bars, I can spend all his money as I please and don't need to answer to anyone. Sam remained impassive, his face not revealing the victory he felt inside. He nodded, thanking Victoria for her confession. What she did not know was that the entire conversation had been recorded on a recorder hidden in his pocket, irrefutable evidence of her guilt. Thank you, Victoria, said Sam, getting up to leave. You just secured Dwayne's freedom. And so, with a recorded confession and the truth finally revealed, Sam Hudson was ready to free Dwayne Lancaster from the injustice he had suffered and bring Victoria Lancaster to justice. With Victoria's recorded confession and all the evidence gathered, Private Detective Sam Hudson went straight to the police. The story of Manhattan socialite Victoria Lancaster, who had become a murderer, spread through the city like wildfire. Victoria was arrested, and her reign of manipulation and betrayal came to an end. Dwayne Lancaster, who had spent months behind bars for a crime he did not commit, was finally released. He emerged from the shadows of injustice as a changed man, still trying to understand the ordeal he had been through. The real twist came when Dwayne, now a free man, decided to visit Victoria in prison. He needed answers. He needed to understand why the woman he loved had betrayed him and ruined his life. Inside the sterile environment of the prison, Dwayne found Victoria. She was sitting on the other side of the cold glass, her normally perfect blonde hair now a mess, but her blue eyes still carrying the same coldness. Dwayne, she said, her voice echoing through the prison phone. Why, Victoria? Dwayne asked, his voice trembling with suppressed emotion. Why did you do all this? Why did you betray our love, ruin my life? Victoria looked at him, her cold gaze meeting his. And then, she smiled. Not a smile of regret or sadness, but a malevolent smile, one that sent shivers down Dwayne's spine. Because I wanted to, Dwayne, she replied, her voice cold and emotionless. Do you think I'm going to spend my whole life with a guy like you? I just wanted your money, but even for that, you're no good. And with those words, Victoria Lancaster's true nature was revealed. She was a woman who had destroyed the life of an innocent man simply because she could. And Dwayne, now free, had the chance to rebuild his life, away from Victoria's toxic shadow. Victoria's cruel response left Dwayne perplexed and shattered. He realized that he never truly knew the woman he had shared his life and dreams with. The revelation of Victoria's true nature and the extent of her malice left him in a state of shock and disbelief. However, the shadows of betrayal could not keep Dwayne Lancaster captive forever. With time, he began to rebuild his life, learning to trust again and to love. He opened new restaurants and rediscovered his passion for cooking. In the pulsing heart of Manhattan, Dwayne emerged from the ashes of his past, proving that even the darkest shadows cannot extinguish the light of hope. Meanwhile, Victoria languished in prison, her beauty and wealth consumed by time. The woman who had once controlled the hearts and minds of men with her manipulation now faced the weight of her actions. Alone and abandoned by all, she was forced to confront the truth of her own nature, facing judgment from herself and from those she once called friends. The shadows of betrayal echoed through the lives of Dwayne and Victoria, but each found a different destiny. While Dwayne rediscovered hope and passion, Victoria succumbed to the weight of her own destruction. And so, in a city where truth and lies intertwine like threads of a carpet, the story of Dwayne Lancaster's betrayal, love, and redemption unfolds, a story as surprising as life itself. And so, dear viewers, we have reached the end of this impressive story, a plot full of love, betrayal, and redemption that took us from the bright lights of Manhattan to the coldness of a prison cell. The story of Dwayne Lancaster, a man who had everything, lost everything, and then fought to regain his freedom and dignity. We hope that this story has been as engaging for you as it has been for us to tell it. May it serve as a reminder that not everything is as it seems, and that sometimes truth is stranger than fiction. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to our channel for more incredible stories like this. Share this video with your friends and family, and don't forget to leave your comments below. We want to hear what you thought of this story. And as always, thank you for watching, and until next time. Stay well and keep seeking the truth, wherever it may be. Goodbye.